Let's take a drink of my coffee before it starts, and then I have to talk. Well, I don't have to talk, but... you know. 9 a.m. 9 a.m. Let's just keep saying it over and over again. 9 a.m. Oh, here we go! Bop. Oh, we're starting right off with the trailer. Is it another Fire Emblem character? What the hell? What is this? Oh, this is cool. Whoa! Fucking Luigi. Wait, what is this? I don't recognize this. I just saw Castle Barracks and I was like, oh no, Fire Emblem. Wait, what? Oh my god, is it Castlevania? No fucking way. Dude, no fucking way! It's Simon Belmont! What?! No fucking way! Oh my gosh, Tim is gonna be screaming at this. What? Oh, this is Namco. Or, no, it's not Namco, it's Konami, isn't it? Oh, come on. Da 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 da. Come on! Jeez, I don't have, like, anything open. Give me a break. Oh, brother. Hold on. Okay, let's try that. Oh my gosh. Fucking Simon Belmont. Da, 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 da. Is this an assist trophy? Oh my gosh. Dracula assist trophy? Oh, that would be hilarious. Wait, is that... oh, come on! Good lord. Okay, hold on. Let me just pause this. Okay, that should be good. So, Richter! That's cool! Oh, wait, is he an Echo Fighter? Oh, that's cool. He's an Echo Fighter, probably. He's gotta be, right? Alucard? Was that Alucard's gotta be an assist trophy? No fucking way. Oh my gosh, they actually got Castlevania in Super Smash Bros. Oh man, that is so totally not who I thought was gonna make it in. Whoa. Okay. Whoa.
Hello. I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sword Limited. This is a follow-up to our recent announcements about Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Without further ado...
further ado-do. I can't believe this.
The legendary vampire Simon hunter Belmont. From the Castlevania series, Simon Belmont, is finally joining the roster.
What?
He's been given a bit of a makeover.
He's got the same pose. He has, like, the same walk cycle!
Holy whip, the far-flinging vampire.
He's got, like, same walk cycle.
Into attack, and it's a bit slow, but I think its average reach during normal attacks is longer than any other fighter's.
Oh, and he can aim it, and he can aim it can up or down or.
His special
so cool.
Attacks are very recognizable. The axe.
Yeah. Uh huh.
Cross.
Nice.
Holy water.
Oh my gosh.
And uppercut.
and uppercut. You know, the classic move from Castlevania 1, uppercut.
And his final smash is called
Grand Cross, of course, yeah. Duh. That is so cool. Oh my gosh, this is so freaking cool. Dracula's Castle. Well, it's called Castlevania.
Other than Dracula's Castle, it's the darkest of stages in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. When an attack hits one of the candlesticks,
the item will appear. You hit the candlesticks.
In this stage, bosses from across the Castlevania series will rear their ugly heads.
The creature and Flea Man. Death, of course. Oh, Carmilla. Oh, right! She was in fucking... Oh, which games was she in? I know she was in Circle of the Moon, right? Who? Huh? Question mark.
Can't forget to mention the music. For this stage, we will incorporate 34 music tracks.
What? I saw Can't Wait Until Night.
Is very popular among our music team, and they were excited to work on these arrangements.
That is so overkill.
Once Blue Moon, Simon's immortal rival will appear.
Oh, this remix is fucking awesome. This is not who I expected.
Reborn every 100 years. He is eternally fated to
That's it?
War
I thought it was that. I thought it was. Oh. God, this thing. Hold on.
Under what conditions will he appear? Time will tell.
I can't believe this.
Now, for a brand new assist trophy.
Alucard, yeah, I thought so,
Alucard,
yeah.
Son of Dracula, will lend his steel in battle. He wields the Chrysogram, transforms into a bat, and dodges attacks by assuming mist form.
Oh, that is so freaking cool!
Starring role in Castlevania: Symphony of the Night.
That is so
like
fucking cool, man!
He's susceptible to attack. And
I can't believe that if this is the only other newcomer. What a weird character! I thought, like.
And we have one more fighter for you.
Wait, a whole? Oh,
the
yeah, Richter.
Hunter who starred in classics like Castlevania: Rondo of Blood. Richter Belmont joins the battle.
What a weird
Richter
choice!
Echo Fighter based on
like, this is such a weird Those choice!
The same. His look, voice, and animations all set him apart. Besides, the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate version of Simon can perform moves derived from Richter in his original games, so it's hard
yeah.
to say who's really echoing who. I hope you'll enjoy them both.
Well, Richter was an Echo Fighter when he debuted. Practically.
I'd like to introduce two more Echo Fighters from completely different series.
Oh, nice.
While we're on the topic.
Excellent. I can't wait.
Please take a look.
I can't wait. What do we got? Oh, actual another Fire Emblem character. Oh, it's Crom. Okay, well, Diana's gonna be happy. 3 exclamation marks. Finally. Oh, a remix of maybe this is a different version of Id, or maybe this is a remix of Id Purpose. I don't know. I haven't played much Fire Emblem. He trips carrying a present, and Lucian is like, "Are you okay?" This is awesome. Okay, that's cool. I'm into it. He finally made it in. Okay, yeah. I thought if Dark Samus made it in, she was gonna be as an Echo Fighter. Man, 4 Metroid fighters! Just all of a sudden, 4 Metroids! 4 Metroid reps. Met-reps. Cool. Da, 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 da. This is a really weird, like, minor key rendition of this song. Da. Well, maybe not minor key, but it sounds more imposing. I thought that if Dark Samus made it in, she was gonna be an Echo Fighter. She's got enough material for her own moveset, but there was no way they'd be able to resist the temptation to make it easy on themselves by making her an Echo Fighter, but hey, I'm happy. That's cool.
And Dark Samus joined the battle. You may have seen this coming. Both fighters have been highly requested.
And that's
different than the fighters
that is not an entirely...
As you can see, depending on your settings, you can either display all fighters separately.
I'm losing track of my. That's not explicitly either her Metroid Prime 2 or Metroid Prime 3 design. Her Metroid Prime 2 design is sleeker than that. Her Metroid Prime 3 design is chunkier.
This time, we plan to reveal the design of every fighter before the game launches. We'll have a few more to announce later, so stay tuned.
A few more Echo Fighters. There were gonna be more new fighters.
Allow me to introduce some of the stages we haven't shown before.
I'm excited. How are we doing? I set it to 240p, so it's probably gonna look pretty poopy, but oh well, that's the price we pay for good frame, for a half-decent frame rate, and less buffering. Okay, these aren't stages we haven't seen. Oh, Twi's gonna lose his mind over that! Brinstar Depths, yes! Excuse me. Oh, there's the fish! 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 You know the Pokemon League! Oh, it's like... Oh, no! Right, that was in 3DS. Magikant is still here with the Flying Man! Man, that animated Flying Man is so cool. Gamer is still here. Okay, good, because Gamer is an awesome stage. Oh, man, the new final destination. Oh, I like it. It's like red and black with spires. It kind of reminds me of the design I had for Smash Bros. Assault. But new Donk City Hall. Oh, it flies around. Nice, one of these fly around stages. They got to make more of these because it's a good way to show off in a big area without making too big of a stage. This is very cool. Pauline, there she is. Ooh, so happy. Nice. They had to have something from Odyssey. I'm not surprised. I expected this. I would have expected this. I didn't make any. Nobody cares. Nobody cares if you actually technically predicted this. You didn't.
We put a lot of effort into enhancing the look of the stages and rebalancing them as well.
You can play on the old school styles. That's so cool.
The stage total is turning out to be pretty impressive.
That's so cool.
Totals in previous games.
Man, holy shit! 103. They're gonna need pages.
Include Battlefield, Final just for the, in Big Battlefield, you know. We'd have exactly 100.
Nice.
But take a look at the stage selection.
Holy cow! There's too many of them.
Can also be transformed into both Battlefield and Omega.
Oh, so happy! I was asking for that. More than 300. Like back in Smaforsh. All of these Battlefield forms. Because Battlefield is way better than Final Destination.
From the beginning.
Dude, I want to unlock things.
Additionally, you have the option to turn off stage.
Okay, cool. Stage hazards off. That's cool.
If you're looking for a change of pace and don't want to be interrupted by hazards, select this option for a less chaotic experience.
Yeah, but you still have the normal layout.
The order of the stages matches the order in which they were introduced.
Reset
in the
before. I saw Newport. Like, oh, we already knew the New Park City was going to be in here though.
Regarding stages, we have a little surprise.
Who?
Please take a look.
A new stage? A new amount! Okay. What the hell?
Check that out. While playing, the stage can transform around you. But first,
okay.
You must select the stage more.
Okay. Okay, I was gonna say,
pick two stages on the stage select menu.
Oh, it's not random? Is there a random option?
Choose any stages you'd like.
Because a random option would be really cool. Just have a match that goes on for, what was that? What was that stage before? Hold on. What was that stage before?
For the player,
Calamari Incantation, yes! I mean, it was obviously gonna be in there.
And this feature is making a return.
There's no way they wouldn't put Calamari Incantation
Until
in there.
Until now, each stage had its own set of music tracks. But this time, the tracks are organized by series instead.
Oh, nice.
As long as you're playing on a stage based on The Legend of Zelda.
Because I remember thinking that. I remember thinking, man, I wish I could play this song on this stage, but I couldn't. That's good.
Now
I like
the
that.
Total number of music tracks from stages.
Oh, God.
This is also ultimate.
Holy shit.
More than
800. It slows down and then it starts going back faster again. That's hilarious.
Like menus and fanfare. Nice. Then there's actually about 900 compositions.
Wow.
If you played them all in
that's
a
more than 10, so it's a lot.
Or stopping, there's more than 28 hours worth of music.
Jesus Christ. That's gonna be a hit on my hard drive.
Are a big part of video game history, and the result is a massive library of memorable music. All of this.
Wait, did they get everything?
This in itself is extraordinary. Of course, there's a sound test menu as well.
Did they get all the previous songs?
We've sorted all of the tracks by game series.
Why do they still have durations, though? Why can't we just have the loop?
An album for each series.
Like, I mean, you can, but I'm pretty sure it's probably going to be like the loop in Smash in Smaforsh, where like
one title rather than a series,
where it still fades out and then just plays again. It's like, why? Just do what Brawl did and have it play constantly.
Sort them in any order you like, anytime, as much as you want.
Friday feeling. Yeah, you can wear headphones. Uh-huh. We knew that.
In handheld mode, you can play music.
Oh! Okay, that's cool.
Using your Nintendo Switch as a music player.
That's cool. I wonder what the battery usage is like.
A huge variety of music has been collected for the game, and you can sample some
that's
of
a nice
Luigi's
Mansion
on the
remix.
Official website. We're planning to add selections basically every week.
City Trial! Nice. Oh man, my favorite part of Smash! Rules!
But I'd still like to show you some things about the multiplayer battle rules.
Okay, what about the single player? What about the single player though?
Now the first thing you will select is the rules. If you
Subspace 2. It's
set,
never gonna happen, but Subspace 2.
With those rules at any time.
Wait, this is Wrecking Crew!
In addition to time battles,
I think that was in Smash 4 though, right?
Treated as one of the standard Smash modes. There's a different feeling of intensity in these battles.
Oh, they explode now. Wow.
This time, stage selection comes before fighter selection.
That's
this way,
weird.
You can pick a fighter based on how well suited they are for the stage.
It's weird, but cool. It's gonna be weird having that suddenly be different.
In sudden death, you not only start with 300% damage, but the camera will steadily zoom in. This creates a nice sense of urgency.
Yeah, that's scary, man. Game set! Hoo-ah! Final Smash meter.
Chargeable Final Smashes are now a selectable option.
Like Super Punch Out.
Your Final Smash meter.
So it's like literally Limit Break. That's cool. That's nice. Oh, a weaker version. Okay. That's cool. I like that.
When you apply
that's
this
interesting.
To a match, things can get really flashy. If you're up for a party, please try it out.
Man, that you gotta get up high for that. You really gotta get up high for that for Lucas's Star Storm. Battle modes.
There are other
you fight.
To the battle modes too.
Okay, but what about single player? Squad strike, scrum debate. Yeah. Man, Simon was so chunky. He's a chunk master.
To decide the winner, each player will use 5 consecutive fighters in one battle.
Oh, interesting. We already had tourneys.
We're also including tourney mode. Choose the
we already had tourneys.
And the game will automatically structure a tournament bracket. Up to 32 players can join the tournament.
Well, actually, were there tourneys in Smaforsh? I don't remember. I never played. If there were, I never played them. Smashdown. Are you ready for the SmackDown?
Smashdown. After a battle in this mode, the previously selected fighters will no longer be available to use in the next battle. So each player must select a different fighter.
That's scary.
It definitely pays off to be skilled with multiple fighters.
Oh man, can you imagine the tournaments with that?
Your opponent is good with before they can.
Cool. Instantly banned
in
competitive
mode. They feature an exclusive stage. We've displayed a grid, so it's easy to measure distance and more.
Interesting.
You can also display launch distance.
Nice. Oh, with the with the DI
at 0% damage. And the blue line is for 100% damage.
Okay, never mind. I thought it was for
the
directional input.
Is factored in at the moment of impact.
Well, that's cool. Class. Okay, yeah. We knew this was going to be here.
Single player mode in which players battle against a series of fighters will return in the form of classic mode.
That's what it's always been called.
Each fighter has a set series of stages and opponents they will face.
I mean, okay.
Now, let me introduce you to some new items, Pokemon, and
come on, there's gotta be more single player than just classic mode. Oh, Dixie Kong? Dixie Kong, right? It's gotta be Dixie Kong. Oh no, it's the banana! Duh! Why did I think we were going to the assist trophies already? Looks like a garbage can, tastes like 10 tacos! That's from, Mario and Rabbids, yeah? Killing Edge. Nice. What is that? What is that from? Killing Edge. I recognize that name, but I don't know. Death Scythe! Instantly KOs fighters who are badly damaged. Whoa! That's devilish. Staff. Whoa! Ramblin' Evil Mushroom! No way! That is so cool! She comes in. Oh boy. That's funny. What do we got? What do we got? Who do we got? Can't wait to see! Woo! Oh damn. Of course. Oh my gosh, he's like a... You can grab onto him! He's terrain! Avra, what the fuck does he even do? He just he teleports people away. Interesting. Well, that's weird. Oh no, DDD. Solgaleo. Yeah, we knew Solgaleo was in here. Solgaleo. Who knows even? Whatever. That's a cool looking attack. Mimikyu. Yes. Of course. Whoa. This reminds me of my assist trophy idea for Doctor. Oh my gosh, it just kills them! Yeah, Pukumuku just does damage when you hit it. Vulpix and Alolan Vulpix, so happy. So cute. Marshadow, cool. Ditto! Does he just transform? Oh, he transforms into a fighter! Oh, that's cool. What? Oh shit. Nice! But you can't just casually drop that! He just randomly runs in. Awesome, man! Zero! Go Zero. Hit that B with your sword. Nice, Knuckles. And Knuckles. What was the next one? Crystal! Okay, she's an assist trophy. Cool. Claptrap! Where is King K. Rool? You're so close! You're so- Did you see Mario's face? Oh, Chef Kawasaki, cool. I can't believe Mario is fucking dead. Gray Fox. Wasn't he already in here? Oh, I guess he's coming back, because Snake came back. Nikki! Oh, nice! Oh, Shovel Knight is an assist trophy. That's weird. I thought for sure he would be a fighter eventually. The moon! Oh my god, that's terrifying! Wow, that's freaky! Oh, jeez! I can't believe Shovel Knight is an assist trophy. All of them. I thought for sure he was gonna be a fighter eventually.
Another powerful one has just arrived.
Come on. Huh? Who the fuck is it? What the hell? Whoa. Oh, is this Monster Hunter? I don't know.
From the Monster Hunter series.
Oh, it is Monster Hunter.
Buffalo swoops in.
Oh, is this an assist trophy? I was thinking, this isn't a fighter, is he? We thought Ridley was ridiculous. Suddenly, this guy appears as a fighter. That would have been hilarious.
First character to appear as both.
Interesting. I always thought it would be cool if some of the boss characters could appear as assist trophies too, also.
Before we go, I'd like us to take a quick look at the main menu.
Yeah, okay, but what about the single player mode? You got classic, that's it? That can't be it. Oh, you got something great out there. It looks like it starts with an S!
As you can see, there's a mysterious mode here, but we can't talk about that just yet. Also, there's a dashboard on the right side of the screen. This can be accessed at
any time
by pressing the ZR button. Maybe
it's not the stage builder. We already know this. Don't we?
That's all for today's announcement. The entire development team is putting all of their energy into finishing the game, so please be patient until launch day. Thank you so much for watching.
The stomps. Oh my god. It's a villain rep. For someone. No way. No way did they actually do it. No way. Oh my god. Did they actually do it? Did they actually do it? Did he? Even mad. There he is. Yes. Oh my god. I'm so happy. They actually Oh my god. They did it. Oh, that's his final. Of course it is. Of course that's his final smash. Oh my gosh. This is the first time he's appeared in a game since, like, 2006! He was in Mario Super Sluggers! My number one pick after Ridley! Man, he's so large. He's so mighty. I can't believe how mighty he is. Simon. Richter. Crom. Dark Samus. King K. Rool is in Smash! Yes! Oh my god.